Hey everyone, I've got something that you really need to know about if you're into your handbags. I've got a few bags I'm going to show you that are all under, like they're, a lot of them are £600, but actually there's one banger in this video and it's about £580 and it's really nice. And I think when you see it, you might be quite surprised. I was. When I saw it, and I'm going to link to everything in this video below, but when I saw it online, I was like, how is it that much money? And I haven't opened it yet, but I think it's a reasonable size as well. So for any of you who want to add to your bag collection or get into bags or buy your first designer bag, have a look at this because it's really nice. And as I go through, I've been shopping and I've bought a few things online and I'm going to try things on. I've got a really nice Zimmerman top I'm going to show you. I'm going to try things on as I go, edit this back, and you can also tell me what you all think about the things that I've bought, whether I should keep or return. Now the first is this top, which I fear on camera looks quite weird, but there's a mirror here. When I look at it in the mirror, I really like it. So it's got a polo neck on the top, and then it's got these open sections here. And if you're thinking, well, how am I going to wear a bra with that? I've actually found the best bra ever. I'm wearing it at the moment, and you can adjust it for any top. Like, even if the neckline's really in, it's got loops that go all the way around the cup and you can take the hook thing off and you can have the loop like there if you need to have it so that you can get it really thin. And if I can find it, I'll link to it because it's a really good bra. You will never have a problem again if you just buy that and own it. So the first top is here. Now, a lot of the things I bought as well, I got on sale. So this was, I think, 40% off. I'm not sure if there's stock of this left now. It's kind of like a ribbed jumper, so it actually feels quite warm, although it's really like a tight knit. So that's the first item. Let me know what you think. Now, before I move on, I'm going to get straight into this bag that I've been telling you about. And I have got four bags that are in this price category. One I can see on the floor, and actually this one I love more than I thought I was going to love it. 580 something pounds, comes really nicely packaged in the Gucci. I do like Gucci wrapping, do you? Really do like it. Let's see what this is and how much can fit in it. It already feels substantial. Wow. Look at that. Look at the width you've got there as well. So it's not like a flat pouch. You can't actually get stuff in it. And this is the kind of thing. Do you know what you can do with this? This is like the Louis Vuitton toiletry pouch. You are going to be able very easily, oh, it's lined with suede as well. Very easily, you're going to be able to get a bag organizer for that and attach a chain either side. Should we try something? I think I want to try it. I don't have a bag organizer, but I do have a chain and I might be able to demonstrate this kind of. Give me a second. And you can get any drop length on the chain. I'm working with the only chain that I have. I think it's quite nice and I think it's practical. I'm going to show you everything that fits in it as well. If you're thinking I quite like that, how much fits in, then hopefully this will demonstrate it for you. I also think, for the guys watching, I know a lot of you have told me that you use pouches like this and you like to kind of carry them under your arm. Like, I know a lot of you said the same thing about the Louis Vuitton toiletry pouch. And also there is a Gucci pouch that is all over leather and it's got the double G monogram in it. And I know a lot of you have said to me, I would like to put all my stuff in it and just carry it round. And I think this is perfect unisex. So for any of the guys watching, if you're thinking, I quite like that, could it work? I definitely think it's going to work for all. Cannot believe how much this bag fits. It's a makeup brush there. Keys. And if you check it out, so I've got two phones. Lipstick, powder, makeup brush, keys. My card holder's in there. If you're not someone who likes to use a card holder and you've got a full-on wallet, no problem at all. The next bag is one that I thought about trying because I walked past Tom Ford a couple of weeks ago and I saw this bag in the window and I thought it was going to be really expensive, but when I checked it out online, it's It's not like cheap. You know what these bags are like. It's really difficult to get anything that's around 500 or less, which is why I like that Gucci bag there. But this is an alternative to that you know, the Prada little nylon bag? This is quite nice. Do you know, what I saw in the window was actually, there's like a dark brown glossy color, and I almost wish I got that instead. But this is not, it doesn't feel like nylon. It feels more like a really thick satin. It's from Tom Ford. And you know, I mentioned with the Prada one, when that bag first came out, it was £180. And for £180, because that bag's a wristlet, so it didn't have a top handle, didn't have a crossbody. And for £180, that bag was brilliant. But then it kept jumping up, and now that bag is £400. And I think when it hit £400, there are other bags you could consider for not too much more, that actually, in many ways, are more usable than a wristlet bag that's £400. Do you sort of mean? 180, good. 400, do you want something that's more of a bag? This is quite a bit more. I actually think the best alternative to the Prada is that Givenchy one that I told you about a couple of weeks ago. And I had a 10% off at the time, which got the price right down on that. But the thing is, that 10% now has expired. So sorry for any of you who wanted to use that. But this is a good alternative as well, if you like the idea but you don't like the nylon so much.
The great thing with bucket bags is lots tend to fit. So let's go makeup brush, phone, my second phone, card holder, lipstick, compact mirror, and keys. And as you can see inside, it's not even halfway full. Do you see that? Not even halfway full, and you can fit so much more in that. It's one of the things I really do love about bucket bags, is they tend to be cheaper than your regular bags, but also they fit a lot more and they can be a lot more practical.
It's got a top handle which isn't removable, and it's also got a crossbody and shoulder strap on it. And also the dust bag, because I don't know about you, but when I buy a bag, it's about all the packaging as well. It's about the dust bag, it's about the bag that it comes in. And the bag is like a microfiber, it feels like suede. Before I show you the final Gucci bag, this is the wild card that when I saw it, I thought, it's okay. And now it's turned up, I really like it. And it's this. This bag, you can get it in a couple of styles. There's this, but you can also get it instead of the black canvas, because this is like a canvas material, you can get it in pink. It's got weight behind it. It's a chunky bag, and all of this is crystallized, and the crystals are not glued on, they're actually set into the bag with claws. And I also like, I think it's quite a nice touch, but on the bottom of the bag, it's got the logo. And for me, as an evening bag, I like it. I do really like it. I like it more than I thought I was going to. And actually, if you know the Prada reissue that's covered in crystals, I adore that bag. That's a really nice bag. But if you don't want to spend that money, I'm looking at this and I'm like, I know it's not Prada and it's Alexander Wang, but that's still a good brand. But it's quite a nice alternative. Just to say as well, this bag is really, really structured. If you try and squeeze it, it doesn't lose its shape at all. I'm really squeezing here. I'm gonna keep this bag for sure. It's very robust. Now for this other Gucci bag, which I haven't opened, a bit like the last one. What I quite like to do on these is, I don't always open the bag before going on camera, because I like to see it with you, you know, for the first time. This already, I can tell, is a lot bigger than I had it down for, which is good. And comes in two colours. It comes with brown leather or with cream. And I nearly went for cream. But in the end, I thought, I'm going to try brown. And this is what I like about it. You know the Christian Dior saddle bag, how when you wear it, it's got the logo there? So's this. It's nice. It's really nice. Let's see how much we can fit in this, because there might be some of you going, yeah, I like that, but it does look small. We'll try and see how much fits in.
So this, if I zoom you in, see what fits in this. Got my regular size phone here, no problem. What I also like about this is on the inside, some of their bags come with it. You cannot remove this. Comes with a clip that you can put your keys on, which is quite good because sometimes I worry that I drop my keys or something. But anyway, my phone's in there, card holder's in there, lipstick is in there, powder is in there, keys. I've got loads on my keys, but look, keys fit in there. And bear in mind, as I say, I have loads on my key ring. Let's close it. Look, no, there's no distorting of the bag. The things in it don't make it difficult to open or close.
This is the Zimmerman top I was telling you about, and it's annoying because there's this tag here, which is kind of, it's pulling the top, so it's not, on that side at least, it doesn't look proper, but on this side it's better. And it's really nice, it's got like a corset type design on the front and on the back. And I thought this would be so nice for summer or for going away. And I like the kind of purple color in it. It's made out of a linen as well. So if you are thinking about the summer months already, I think this is going to be quite a comfortable top to wear in the day. And I've just put it here with the Tom Ford bag, which is the black satin. And I'm already thinking that I probably rather prefer the bronze colour of this bag, because I saw the bronze in the window of Tom Ford, but I saw it after I'd ordered this colour. And when I saw the bronze, I thought, actually, that's quite a unique colour and it's quite nice. But here is this bag on. And the handle on this has got like a chain handle, which is quite nice, crossbody strap. And the crossbody strap does come off. So if you just want to use the top handle, the top handle comes off as well. There we go, so you can remove either or. I took my regular size, by the way, and I would say, if you're between sizes, I think size down, because I'm finding it a little bit loose. Like, the whole back is elasticated, and because of that, the bust area is quite loose. Like, I could do with one size down, I think, to fit properly. Because it is quite loose on the bust, and I think if it was a size down, it would be better. So it's just to let you know that if you're bigger busted, take your regular size. If you are smaller busted or you're generally between sizes, I think go a size down. Do any of you own these bags? What do you think of them? I quite like the semicircle. Well, I like both Gucci bags actually, but I really like that crystallized Alexander Wang bag. But then I also like the Tom Ford. Quite like all of them. Let me know what you think. I hope you've enjoyed this casual chat hangout. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you in the next video.